Hey, RV family, keep it I keep it tight. My name is Jay Morris, the review guy, reviewing music for the love of music, and I'm back again to bring you another video. And in this one, I'm going to be covering the new Protomartyr record entitled Ultimate Success Today. This is the fifth studio length album by the Detroit, Michigan rock band. This is out now on Domino. Protomartyr have been able to pretty safely secure themselves a spot amongst the best of the best when it comes to this new wave of post-punk absurdists that arose around the turn of the last decade, bursting onto the scene with some catchy, albeit overly nostalgic releases. But the vintage aesthetic that they originally performed in and rose to prominence with slowly started to whittle away, and you could see trace elements on their releases as it progressed, but something was definitely changing. Everything they embodied really took a turn. These oddball projects displayed a knack for being able to combine a variety of abrasive rock stylings in the most abstract sense together to just rip through these really busy compositions. Artistically, nowadays you can draw parallels all across the map. I think some of the ones that are most on the nose would definitely be Swans, as well as Daughters, Wild Beasts, as well as the many projects that Toby Driver has been associated with. Specifically, I catch a lot of whiffs of Modeling of the Well and KO Dot. These tracks, while they do have this restrained feeling, they also feel very progressive in the sense of how they progress. Now, Protomartyr has always been an interesting band for me. I think they are one of the better post-punk bands that really grew in the 2010s. And I think Ultimate Success Today is their most artistically sound and well-refined record to date. In many ways, the thing that I feel the most listening to this, fans of Daughters' critically acclaimed records, You Won't Get What You Want, do not miss out on this record, please. It reminds me so much of it, and pretty much all of the reasons that I loved that record so much. These tension-building instrumentals that ring out as the vocalist Joe Casey just soars over them with a variety of vocal stylings, whether it be staccato shouts or hushed, intimate, deadpan singing. And while the post-punk is still here, I think that the short-lived New York no-wave scene has had a tremendous impact on the band's sound going forward, especially on this record. The at times dry delivery of these borderline spoken word poetic bits really do recall the anti-music tepidness of the counterculture from that mini movement. This record is a slow burner, and it is a bone chiller, and it is the musical equivalent of Blue Balls as it tortures you with each note. And things swell, such as the noisy bits on Processed by the Boys or the gritty, grizzly, low rumble guitar tone on the track Tranquilizer, it almost always has a really harsh bite to it. Even the tracks that show more of a toned down melodic edge are still very well put together, in my opinion. While Modern Business Hymns is by far one of my least favorite tracks on the entire record, the psychedelic, lackadaisical, drifty riffs that play out in the backdrop and layer the rhythms coming out of the guitar on this track just are intoxicating and very well mixed. They are mixed to perfection. I'm gonna be honest, if there's one thing that I can praise more than anything else, it's just generally the mix to this record sounds very well made. The equalization of everything is spot on. They really make sure everything is completely audible, which is something very important when you have a very chaotic rock sound that occasionally will become very noisy. It's very important to have some sort of cohesion that ties it all together, and luckily Protomartyr understands that and utilizes that to their advantage. I guess the only tiny thing is Joe's vocals can occasionally become an afterthought to the cacophonous instrumentation, specifically when it becomes very noisy and chaotic. He can kind of drift in the background a bit, and his vocals can feel a little bit scant and dry, like maybe they could have been touched up a tad bit more, because they'll do the same mixing effects that they use regularly on the rest of the record when it is very softer and it's a little bit more toned down. So when it really busts into like a galloping riff or a really loud section, he can kind of fade out, but that may have been intentional for all I know. Also, lyrically, it can on occasion be difficult to discern the meaning of a song on first listen. I think that's where some of that Swans influence comes in a way. And also another parallel you could definitely make with Daughter's record. But the vagueness in the lyricism and storytelling on this record does result in it feeling very raw and primitive in a sense. I do think that the brilliance in this record is how the compositions can blur the line between the toned down and between the heavy. Better than pretty much anything I have heard on a Protomartyr record up until this point. Because even when the instrumentals can seem a little bit surface level, they do a great job of adding in little bits and bobs and embellishments to give it a little bit more depth, give it a little bit more touch and dimension to the entire thing. Bass, clarinet, alto, sax, flute, and clarinet all appear on this track listing at various sections, and they never overstay their welcome. They're just little blips on the radar that add in a little bit of a healthy add-on. And when they pop in, they are healthy additions because they complement what they are doing very well. While not every single second of this record is fireworks, it's engrossing as all hell. The discordant sounds on this record are intoxicating to listen to, and a rigid but well-made production style lends itself to just how jarring this all feels. The more tiny genres that are associated with rock and punk that you are aware of, I feel like the more you will enjoy this record, because Protomartyr has done a great job of implementing them subtly to make it just seem like one beast, but there are a lot of little avenues and a lot of different branches to this tree that is this record, and as a result of that, their current sound that comes from a love of the genres they perform in, as well as just sheer experience. I do believe this is their best record. I guess in the future, what I would like to see and what I'd love to see is them not be afraid to not restrain themselves. Some of these tracks could definitely do to be a little less low-key and be a bit more busy, be a bit more noisy, really lay into it, because that's some of the best moments on this record and some of the most emotionally poignant tracks. At times, the general low-keyness can cause Joe's vocalizations or the instrumentals in general, or especially the lyricism, to feel a little bit understated, and as a result of that, the record can occasionally feel a little bit underestimated. Otherwise though, I am enjoying this record quite a bit. It excites me for the future of Protomartyr, and I'm looking forward to seeing where they go from here and if they continue to lay into this style. What I'm curious to know is, do you guys think that they are going to continue down this path and really lay into this sound full force, considering how far they have come from their initial releases, which were pretty much just some cut and dry great post-punk releases, to whatever the hell they have become now? Either way, I am enjoying it. I'm going to be giving this record an 8 out of 10. And that is a wrap. Have you heard this new Protomartyr record, Ultimate Success, today? If you have, let me know in the comment section below what you thought about it. I would love to discuss the record with you. Be sure to like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to join the review family today and smash that notification bell to be notified of my future uploads. You know who it is. My name is Jay Morse, the review guy. I'm signing off soon. Farewell. And I hear this call.